Hi, I am Prasad. This video is about the last flight of Atlantis. After 30 years of operation of Space Shuttle, Atlantis flew last on 21st July 2011. The shuttle was designed as a reusable spacecraft which can be launched like a rocket and land like an aircraft. The first Space Shuttle flown was Columbia. It was lifted off on 12th April 1981. The Space Shuttle program was stopped in 2011 without any replacement. Russian Soyuz was used to carry astronauts to the space station from 2011 to 2020. Unmanned cargo vehicles were used to carry supplies to the space station. Finally, a spacecraft was made after 9 years. It was launched from American soil with the two astronauts on 30th May 2020. While in orbit, the space shuttle travels around the Earth at a speed of about 17,500 miles per hour. At this speed, the crew can see a sunrise or a sunset in every 45 minutes. STS-1 to STS-135, the shuttle legacy lives on as the shuttle leaves behind an operational space station, which will be operational until 2030. Atlantis was flown by the following crew: Commander Chris Ferguson, Pilot Doug Hurley, Mission Specialist 1 Dr. Sandy Magnus, Mission Specialist 2 Rex Walhain. Atlantis lifts off for its final voyage to the International Space Station. At launch, Atlantis is powered by 3 liquid fuel main engines and 2 solid rocket boosters. 30 seconds into the flight after rollover maneuver, the computer reduces the power to 72% to reduce the aerodynamic forces on the shuttle. After 20 seconds, it is again restored. Solid rocket boosters are burned out and are separated. The 3 main engines continue to power the orbiter, and the 2 small orbiting maneuvering system engines will fire for 1 minute and 23 seconds to give additional thrust. Eight and a half minutes after launch, the main engines are shut off and the external tank is jettisoned. Atlantis is an elliptical orbit of 135 miles at apogee now. Subsequently, it was put in an higher elliptical orbit by firing the OMS engines. Additional orbital round-of-view maneuvers were performed for 2 days for the final docking with the International Space Station. View of the Earth from the Atlantis flight deck. Let us see the factors affecting the launch sequence. The space station is orbiting the Earth at 7.6 kilometers per second and at an altitude of 400 kilometers. The inclination of the space station orbit is 51.6 degrees in respect to the equator. All shuttle launches need to be timed to match the moment when the Earth rotation carries the Space Launch Center below the station's orbit. The space station has just passed the Kennedy Space Center now, and the shuttle is launched so that both the orbits will align. Atlantis is being launched. Space station is orbiting at an altitude of 400 kilometers, and the space shuttle is initially placed in a lower orbit of 225 kilometers. The payload bay doors are opened in the first day. It is required to be opened
as the orbiter's docking adapter is in the forward end of the payload bay. Multi-purpose logistics module can be seen in the back end. Atlantis can be seen here chasing the space station, and it needs to catch up with the space station in the subsequent orbits. A series of engine firing during the first 2 days brought the shuttle to a point 50,000 feet below the station. View of the Atlantis from the cupola module of the space station. Atlantis has arrived below the space station. Before docking, the shuttle jets will carry out the terminal initiation burns to cover the final miles to the station during the next orbit. Now the shuttle is near the R-bar. R-bar is the imaginary line from the station to the center of the Earth. V-bar is in the line of station's orbit. Atlantis control is manual now and is moved closer to the station and is stopped at approximately 182 meters below the station and waits for proper lighting. Atlantis crew performed an 8 minutes backflip, which is called the R-bar pitch maneuver. This is done to enable the station crew to take high-resolution photographs of the shuttle's upper and lower surfaces. Areas of special interest is the bottom thermal protection tiles, nose cap, reinforced carbon-carbon wing leading edge panels. These photographs are downloaded to the mission control, where the experts examine for any damages. After the R-bar pitch maneuver, the commander moves Atlantis through a quarter of a circle to a position about 122 meters directly in front of the station. From here, Atlantis began the final approach to the station's pressurized mating adapter 2 in the Harmony node. Docking two fast-moving spacecrafts is a very delicate and potentially dangerous task. Using the camera mounted on the orbiter's docking system, commander lined up the docking ports of the two spacecrafts. This is the view of the station's mating adapter, seeing through the central line camera on the shuttle's docking system adapter. The standoff cross should be aligned with the vertical and horizontal lines. After the contact, the latches will be automatically engages and a seal on the mating ring creates an airtight joint. Multi-purpose logistic module can be seen on the shuttle's payload bay. It carried supplies, logistics, spare parts to the station and was used to carry back a failed ammonia pump and trash from the station. Atlantis also carried the robotic refueling mission equipments. It was fitted exterior of the station. It was designed to demonstrate and test the tools, technologies, techniques needed to robotically refuel and repair old satellites in the space in the future. Soyuz spacecraft can be seen docked to the station. It will be always available for emergency evacuation of the crew. Using the robotic arm of the space station, the multi-purpose logistic module is being lifted from the payload bay and is being attached to the space station. The robotic arm is being released. Day 11. All the scheduled work has been completed and the space shuttle is ready to be undocked for the last time. During undocking, the latches are released and the springs pushes the shuttle away from the station. Steering jets will be shut off to avoid any inadvertent firing during the initial separation. Once the shuttle is 2 feet from the station, crew turns on the steering jets and carefully moves it further away from the station. Atlantis moves to a distance of 600 feet approximately along the plus V bar. Atlantis carried out a half-lap fly around over the space station. During this maneuver, shuttle crew photographed the space station exterior with special interest to the areas which are rarely seen. The Atlantis crew fired the jets to leave the area and to move towards its initial orbit. Atlantis payload bay doors are closed. Atlantis is on its home stretch now. The speed now is 17,500 miles per hour and it is time to start the deorbit burn. Atlantis is doing a pitch maneuver to fly upside down and backwards. Its twin engines are being fired for 3 minutes. It slows down the Atlantis and drops out of its orbit. Atlantis is turning back to its normal position. The shuttle is on its final approach. It has no engines to provide the thrust in the atmosphere. It needs to glide to the runway like a glider. Atlantis plunges into the atmosphere and its aluminum structure needs to be protected from the enormous amount of heat produced during re-entry. A plasma glow is formed around the shuttle. The angle of attack is increased to about 40 degrees. The bottom thermal protection tiles faces the re-entry heat. The flight path will carry the Atlantis high above the Gulf of Mexico and on to Florida. As the orbiter nears landing sites, the commander takes manual control to line up the runway. Above the ground, the commander pulls up the nose to slow down the rate of descent. The wheel brakes are applied and the speed brakes on the vertical tail opens up. A drag chute is deployed from the back to help in stopping the shuttle. Thus ends the 30 years of shuttle program.